So I'd like to show you something that I've observed in my daily life, which is that shampoo bottles, for most of their lifetime, are pretty well behaved. But when I used up that last little bit of shampoo, all of a sudden the bottle became very annoying, falling all over the place whenever I would give it the slightest little bump. And so the physics of that is pretty interesting and easy to understand. The mass of an empty shampoo bottle was about 40 grams. The mass of the liquid inside is about 340 grams. So most of the mass is the mass of the liquid. When the bottle starts out full, the center of mass is about where the center of the liquid is, which is pretty high in this bottle. As we use up the liquid, the center of mass becomes lower and lower and lower, and that helps the bottle become more stable and more difficult to tip over. But at the very end of its life, when you use up that last 10% of liquid, then instead of the center of mass being low, when they have an empty bottle, the center of mass jumps up rapidly to the center of mass of the geometric center of the bottle. And that means it's much easier to tip the bottle over. So I have a ramp here set to 7 degrees. When I put a full shampoo bottle on that, it's perfectly fine, perfectly happy. That's because the center of mass of this object is on the uphill side of this edge of the bottle, the forward edge of the bottle. This is a bottle filled with about 30% of shampoo. That brings the center of mass to its lowest possible position on the 7-degree ramp. That's completely fine. But for this completely empty bottle, the center of mass now is up near the top, up near the middle. So when I set that on the 7-degree ramp, you can see it just does not stay. But there's another factor that comes into play. And so Allen Yuan developed this demonstration to show the effect of impact, and it's even more extreme than just looking at angle, stability angle. So what we have here is a tennis ball mounted on a string that I can draw back to different angles. He put a protractor here to measure the launch angle and watch what happens as it impacts this shampoo bottle. So you can see that for an angle of 10 degrees, nothing happens, just bounces back. For an angle of 15 degrees, the bottle's still stable. It takes an angle of about 23 degrees in order to give this bottle enough rotational energy or angular momentum in order to raise the center of mass above the stability point and topple. When we have our bottle with the lowest center of mass, again, it's about filled to 30%, again, it's still fairly stable. 5 degrees, bounces off, no problem. 10 degrees, that impact, still, it rocks, but it comes back to stability. It's because the center of mass is low. It takes an angle of about 13 degrees in order to finally knock that bottle over. But the empty bottle is much more annoying than all that. Because the mass is so light, that means it's going to have a large response to an impact. And because the center of mass is so high, it's going to topple over easily. So in this case, it only takes an angle of about 3 degrees in order to knock that bottle over. So much less stable than any of the other configurations. Thank you.